All right, well, Canada, we have too much pot. There's about 400,000 kilograms of cannabis sitting right now on producer shelves. Most of this not even packaged for sale. It's just sitting there. But legal cannabis retailers only sold 13,000 kilograms across the entire country in the month of August. So we are joined now by the Globe and Mail's cannabis reporter, Jameson Burko. Good to have you with us. Welcome back to the Your Morning Studio.
Pleasure to be here, Henry.
This is surprising. Statistics Canada says the average price for a gram of legal cannabis is $10.65, whereas a gram on the black market, so we're told, is $5.93. So that is half the price.
Absolutely.
Is this why we have the surplus? Because it's just cheaper still to get it from the corner than the corner cannabis store.
That's definitely part of it, for sure. I mean, part of it as well is just the rollout of the fact that, you know, the guy on the corner, there's plenty more guys on corners than there are actual legal cannabis stores, right?
Yeah.
So part of it is just a numbers game, Henry, but, you know, it's important to take a step back and just think about how many kilograms was it that you said there? Hundreds of thousands of kilograms. I mean, close your eyes and just, you know, imagine
kilograms.
Ben's last birthday party, and that might even be enough to supply half of that through the whole staff. So maybe that's one way to get rid of the supply issue. That's just, you know, my personal idea.
So the fact that they have all this product sitting at like 400,000 kilograms sitting on the shelves, at the same time, cannabis companies, well, they're expanding.
Yeah.
You know, we have Aurora building almost $2 million square foot facility in Medicine Hat, Alberta. Mm-hmm. Aphria recently announced they're going to ramp up their production here in Ontario, in Leamington. They're going to full capacity. Explain to me the economics of this. You have hundreds of thousands of kilograms of not even packaged surplus on the shelves.
Right.
Companies are expanding, which means they're planning to make and package and sell more. But you can't move the stuff you already have.
Part of it's a long game, Anne-Marie, right? Like, they're thinking 10 years down the line when the market's mature, when there are maybe thousands of stores open across the country.
Right?
Yeah, no, they're totally going to have to take write-downs. That's important. Like, part of it is the long game, but you're right. Part of it is also, in the short term, they were wildly overly ambitious in terms of not just how much product the market could absorb, but how much the market could really expand in the first place,
and how much they wanted.
Well, yeah, because there was this belief that people were willing to pay more for legal cannabis, and that's probably true, mm-hmm. but I think how much more I think that's where the companies fell down.
Okay,
was on this belief that there really was almost no limit to the amount that people would pay to get that legal, safer, more secure source. But again, I'll stress, I'm sure there is a premium people are willing to pay, but it's not double.
But it's not double. So we're heading into, you know, Christmas, and there's a lot of sales this time of year, so are we going to see pot sales? Will we see, you know, like 2-for-1 or a price reduction?
There's rules that forbid that kind of thing, which makes it very difficult, Anne-Marie. And it's part of the thing that I think companies didn't really consider when they were rolling out their big production expansion plans. And I mean, I should stress, companies are starting to pump the brakes on their expansions. Like that Medicine Hat facility that Aurora's building, I know that they're only going to finish part of it and they're going to leave a big chunk of it unfinished until the market catches up. But Canopy, the Tweed marijuana folks, they actually said on their last earnings call, which was just last week, that they need 40 stores a month to open in Ontario for the next year or so in order to essentially have a market big enough to sell product into. That's why it's sitting on shelves not even packaged, right? Because they know they have nowhere to send it.
Good to have you back here.
My pleasure.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.